Good morning, children. In today's class, we are going to learn about volume of a solid obtained by revolving area about an axis. Suppose you see one particular line. It's a single dimension. As it rotates, can you see the line now? As fast as it rotates, I can see only a circle rather than a line. Look at the fan. A fan, as you see three blades, as it starts rotating, can you check the blades now? No, we see only a circle. A bangle, as you see, it's a plain figure, a circle. As it rotates, it forms a sphere. Try it yourself, as you rotate a bangle or a circular shape to get a sphere. Have you noticed it? Yes. So what we conclude? A one dimension, when it rotates, it creates. A line has one dimension. As it rotates, we get a two dimensional. So one dimension gives rise to area. When a two dimension, say a bangle, a circle, as it rotates about a fixed axis, when it rotates, I do not see the circle. I see only the shade, like a sphere, like a ball, which is a three-dimensional area giving rise to volume. A bangle does not have a volume, but as it rotates, if this is a circle, as it rotates, I get a shading like, which almost looks like a three-dimensional figure. So when a two-dimensional figure rotates, we get a three-dimensional figure. And in this section, the figure so obtained, how we are going to find the volume of it? What is the idea? Suppose this is the curve that is rotating about x-axis. Take the small portion of length del x, let me say. The height of it as it is in y-axis, I will call y. It is a small rectangle. As it rotates, the small rectangle will create a small cylinder. A rectangle rotates, it creates a cylinder. But a triangle rotates, it gives rise to a cone. If it is a right-angled triangle, it gives rise to a right circular cone. So we have seen already the circle. As it rotates or revolves about x-axis or y-axis, we arrive at a sphere. So let us take this into account for deriving the formula. When a rectangle piece rotates or revolves about x-axis, I will be able to notice a cylinder. What is volume of cylinder? We remember it is pi r square h. R stands for radius, the whole square. H stands for height. So the whole thing into pi gives rise to volume. In this question, pi as it is, radius is that which is revolving. Y revolves. So y is the radius, I will get y square. What is the height? It is a very small cylinder now. Something like one biscuit, I can say. Like one Marie biscuit, which we have seen. So, it's a very thin cylinder. And the height of the cylinder is a very small thickness, say, del x. Or, when I approximate, I can also call it as dx. This is for one such strip. Suppose, I divide into numerous strips. For the full area that which rotates or revolves, I must find out the entire strip's volume. That is, I need to add. Addition. As n tends to infinity, it becomes integral. From where to where? If I consider A to B, the starting point to ending point, we integrate from A to B. This is the curve, I will say, y equals to f of x. From A to B, about x-axis, it is pi y square dx. Can it revolve about y-axis? Yes, of course. In that case, so this area, that which being rotated or revolved about y-axis, I get the same portion down also. How to get the volume? Now the volume is integral. Says a value c to d. C to d pi x square dy. Let us proceed into exercise problems. Exercise 9.9, question number 1. Find by integration the volume of the solid generated by revolving about x-axis the region enclosed by y equals to 2x square, y is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. Y equal to 2x square. The moment I see, I must be able to identify it is a parabola opening up. Also, it passes through the origin, say 0, 0. When this curve rotates about or revolves about x-axis, this portion comes down and as it rotates, we need till x is equal to 1. I want to find the volume generated by this small portion that being rotated. So, as it is rotated, we will get the shading down also. How to find the area? As I see the portion, it is v equals pi integral a to b y square dx. Pi integral a to b. A to b is 0 to 1 y square. From the question, y square is 2x square the whole square dx. Or pi into integral 0 to 1, 2 square 4, x square, the whole square is x power 4. Keep 4 out. X power 4 becomes x power 5 by 5. Remember the formula. Integral x power n dx is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Having applied the formula between the limits 0 to 1. V equals 4 pi by 5 that is taken out. Wherever x comes 1, it is 1 power 5. Wherever x comes 0, it is 0 power 5. So the answer is 4 pi by 5 cubic units. So volume generated by this enclosure, we get 4 pi by 5 cubic units. Question number 2, find by integration the volume of the solid generated by revolving about x-axis. The region enclosed by y equals e power minus 2x, y0, x0 and x1. They have given you x0 and 1 which we have marked along x-axis. The curve given is y is equal to e power minus 2x which is drawn here. How to get the curve? Let us put some easy values. X 0. E power 0 will be 1. So 0, 1. As x is more and more, you can check it. Then x is infinity. E power minus infinity will be 0. So the curve goes on and on nearing 0. Now this portion, when revolved about x-axis between x is equal to 0 and 1, I get a portion below the x-axis also. To get the volume enclosed by this curve y equals e power minus 2x between x0 x1 and y equal to 0 represents it is revolving about x-axis. Volume of the solid is V equal to pi into integral A to B y square dx. Here A to B is 0 to 1. Y square is e power minus 2x the whole square into dx. That is e power minus 2x the whole square will become 2x into 2. That is e power minus 4x dx. As we integrate, e power minus 4x becomes e power minus 4x by minus 4 between the limit 0 to 1. V equals pi by minus 4 into e power minus 4 into 1 minus e power minus 4 into 0. It is pi by minus 4 into e power minus 4 minus e power 0 is 1. Taking minus symbol in, it is pi by 4 into 1 minus e power minus 4 cubic units, and that is the answer. Question number 3. Find by integration the volume of the solid generated by revolving about the y-axis. The region enclosed by x square equals 1 plus y and y equals 3. X square and right side I have plus y. Here the power 2, here the power 1, so almost it is a parabola opening up. How to find where it cuts x axis or y axis? Put y 0. When I put y 0, I get x square 1 or x is equal to plus or minus 1. And how to check where it cuts y axis? Put x 0, I get y is minus 1. So I must draw the curve where y is equal to minus 1, where x is equal to plus 1 and minus 1. It is opening up. So the curve will be like this. As I know the curve and they have given the line y equal to 3. Given y limits, it is rotating about y axis. So it will create a paraboloid. So how to find the volume of it? Volume equal to pi integral c to d x square dy whenever about y axis is given. What are the limits for y? We know the curve starts from minus 1. So y equal to minus 1. They have given up to y equal to 3. So the limits are volume v equals pi into minus 1 to 3. What is x square from the question? It is 1 plus y dy. As I integrate, now I do with respect to y. 1 will become 1 into y plus y will become y square by 2. Between the limits minus 1 to 3. Put upper limit 3 plus 3 square by 2. Minus lower limit minus 1 plus minus 1 square by 2. Or we get volume is pi into 3 plus 9 by 2 minus of minus 1 plus 1. Here it is 1 by 2 with minus symbol, it is minus 1 by 2. Pi into 3 plus 1, I get 4. 9 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is 9 minus 1 by 2. Simplifying which we get 4 plus 8 by 2 is 4, or volume equals to 8 pi cubic units. Question number 4. The region enclosed between the graphs of y is equal to x and y equal to x squared is denoted by R. Find the volume generated when R is rotated 360 degrees about x-axis. As I read the problem, y equal to x square is a parabola opening up through 0, 0. Y equal to x is a line that is passing through 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, like that. So it is noted by the red line. Now the question is, this region between the line and the parabola, so shaded region, this I call R. This region rotates about 360 degrees about x-axis. What would be the volume generated? Volume generated by y is equal to x minus volume generated by y is equal to x squared between x is equal to 0 and 1. How do I get it? Let us solve the two given equations, y is equal to x and y is equal to x squared. X is equal to x square or x square minus x is 0, x into x minus 1 0, or I get x is equal to 0 and 1. As I know the two values from the diagram, I can also deduce using algebraic method. Once I have found out the limits, let us find out the required volume. Let us call it as V. So, required volume V is between 0 and 1. Volume by line y is equal to x. What is volume formula actually? Pi integral a to b y square dx. By the line, what is y square? It is x square dx minus by the curve. I want y square. Again, it is from 0 to 1, x square the whole square dx. As we integrate, x square becomes x cube by 3 between 0 and 1 minus x square the whole square is x power 4. The formula is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 between the limits 0 and 1. Volume is pi into upper limit 1 by 3 minus lower limit 0 minus pi into upper limit 1 power 5 by 5 minus lower limit 0. As we simplify, pi by 3 minus pi by 5, LCM 15 cross multiply 5 pi minus 3 pi, or we get 2 pi by 15 cubic units. The required volume generated by R is 2 pi by 15 cubic units under the given conditions. Question number 5. Find by integration the volume of the container which is in the shape of a right conical frustum as shown in the figure. They have given the base is 1, the top is 2 and the total height is 2. Let me complete the cone so that it will be easy for us to find out the volume. As we explain the entire cone, CD equals 1, AB equals 2, OC let us take the height to be X, and BC the height given in the question is 2. As I look at the diagram, triangle ODC and triangle OAB are similar. Comparing the like sides, CD by AB equals to OC by OB. From here, CD by AB is 1 by 2. OC is X. OB will be the total. So, what is OB from here? It is x plus 2. From here, half equals x by x plus 2. Let me cross multiply. X plus 2 equals 2x, or 2x minus x is equal to 2. I get x is equal to 2. Once I know OC, I can immediately write what are coordinates of A. Coordinates of A would be x value they have given 2 and y value the entire length, that is 2 plus 2 which is 4. And what would be the coordinates of D? Coordinates of D would be the x value I have 1 and the height x is 2. Once I know A and D, let me find out equation of AD. 2-point formula, y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equals x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. As we substitute, y minus 4 by 2 minus 4 equals x minus 2 by 1 minus 2. Or I get y minus 4 by minus 2, x minus 2 by minus 1. Cancelling the minus symbol together, And as I cross multiply, I get y minus 4 is 2x minus 4. Cancelling minus 4, we get y equals to 2x. What is the question actually? I want the volume of the container. So what is volume of the container? Volume generated by the revolution of AD about y axis from this height to this height. What is this height actually? That is 2. And what is the entire height? That is 2 plus 2, which is 4. So the volume will be the formula when it is about y axis, pi x square dy. So pi integral 2 to 4. What is x square from here? X is equal to y by 2, or x square equal to y square by 4. So I want x square, which is y square by 4 dy. As we integrate, pi by 4 can be taken out. Y square becomes y cube by 3 between the limits 2 to 4. Pi by 4 threes are 12 into 4 cube upper limit minus 2 cube lower limit. Pi by 12 into 64 minus 8, or it is 56 pi by 12. Simplifying which we get 14 pi by 3 cubic units. Therefore, volume of the frustum equals to 14 pi by 3 cubic units. Let us quickly rough through the problem. Given a frustum, we try to complete the cone. As I look at the diagram, here the length is given to be 1, here it is 2, and this height is 2. Let us assume the balance height to be x. As I look at the diagram, ODC triangle, OAB triangle are similar. Comparing the proportional sides, CD by AB equals OC by OB. OC is x, OB will be the total length, that is x plus 2. Cross multiplying and simplifying, we get x is equal to 2. Once I know this height, x is 2. The entire height is 2 plus 2, 4. A coordinates will be x value 2, y value 4. So 2 comma 4. How about D? X coordinate 1 and y will be 2. As I know the 2 points, let me find out the equation of AD, because that is the line which is rotating about y axis to yield the volume. So we have the 2 point formula, substituting which I get y equal to 2x. Volume about y axis is pi integral c to d x square dy. What is x from here? Y by 2. And if I square, it is y square by 4. What are the limits for the frustum from the height x to the total height, that is 4? So 2 to 4, this is 2 height and this is 4. So 2 to 4 y values, because I can treat this line as y axis. 2 to 4. So 2 to 4, we integrate x square dy. As I integrate, x square is y square by 4, keeping 4 out. Y square becomes y cube by 3. Substituting upper limit minus lower limit, we arrive at 14 pi by 3 cubic units. Question number 6. A watermelon has an ellipsoid shape, which can be obtained by revolving an ellipse with major axis 20 cm and minor axis 10 cm about its major axis. Find its volume using integration. Ellipsoid is obtained by revolving an ellipse. Ellipse looks like this, treating this as major axis. X axis, the major axis, and y axis, the minor axis. Given major axis is 20, the entire length 20, or I will say 10, 10. Minor axis 10 tells me 5 here and 5 here. As we know, the equation of ellipse is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. Here, a value, the semi-major axis 10, b value, the semi-minor axis 5. As we substitute, it is x square by 100 plus y square by 25 equals 1. Now, we revolve about x-axis. As we revolve about x-axis, volume of the ellipsoid is from minus 10 to plus 10. So, we will say integral minus 10 to plus 10 pi y square dx, or else it is 2 times integral 0 to 10 pi y square dx. That is, volume, I can say 2 times volume obtained by the curve in first quadrant. So, volume obtained by first quadrant, we multiply by 2 to get the required volume. The volume so generated is pi integral a to b y square dx. From first equation, what is y actually? Let us derive. So, first equation says y square by 25 is 1 minus x square by 100, or 100 minus x square by 100. I want only y square. Cross multiply, it is 25 into. As I cancel and substitute here, pi into integral. What are the limits? We revolve about x-axis. The limits are from 0 to 10. This point I call 10, 0. This point I call 0, 0. So, volume between x is equal to 0, x is equal to 10. 0 to 10 integral 100 minus x square by 4 into dx. Bring by 4 out. 100 will become 100x minus x square becomes x cube by 3 between the limits 0 and 10. Pi by 4 into upper limit 10. 100 into 10 minus 10 cube by 3. The lower limit for both the cases, it is 0. As we simplify, volume is pi by 4 into 1000 minus 10 cube is 1000 by 3. Taking LCM 3, cross multiplying 3000 minus 1000, or it is 2000 pi by 4 into 3. As we cancel, volume so generated is 500 pi by 3 cubic units. Have we completed the problem? No. What we have done is between 0 and 10, that is the volume generated by the first quadrant portion alone. But ellipsoid is obtained by both the portions. So, what we do? This portion, what we did in first quadrant, multiply by 2. So, what is my required volume? 2 into volume by first quadrant. That is 2 into 500 pi by 3, which is 1000 pi by 3 cubic units, and hence the problem.